Welcome. This is the continuing webcast series for our TripScott clients. Today we're joined by Senate President Jeff Atwater. Jeff is the current senator in District 25 that runs along the coast in Palm Beach and Broward County. He was elected in 2002 to the Senate, and previous to that he was in the House, where he was elected in 2000. His roots in Broward run deep. His great-grandfather, Napoleon Bonaparte Broward, was a founder of our county. And so today I welcome Jeff Atwater.
Good to be with you, Ed. Thank you for joining. Let me join you.
As Senate President, sure. Talk about some legislative updates for our clients.
Sure. I think important to Floridians would be a couple of things. One is education in Florida, higher education in Florida, how that has dealt with their Bright Future scholarships and tuition. Another I could touch on would be windstorm insurance and property and casualty insurance. I think would be important for all Floridians. Let me jump quickly to higher ed. I really think this is important for Florida to begin to expand into a much stronger knowledge-based economy. And so what we had to do is the reality that Bright Futures has been an extraordinarily valuable asset for Florida's families. But our tuition rates were the lowest in the country. That's not bad when you think about it in pure terms, that tuition is the lowest in the country, but we were losing quality people out of our universities, and our universities, frankly, were capping enrollment.
Right.
And our children weren't having the chance to proceed on to our state universities, which are our public universities. And the question of their long-term quality was going to be at risk at some point. So we worked with the universities to what we called the decoupling, full advantage of a Bright Future Scholar, full advantage of a prepaid college. But the universities could establish a differential above the base tuition. And if they were to do that, and it was approved, they would have to take part of the scholarship money that came in and part of the differential into a place that would be there for scholarships for families that could not afford it. So that was a big transition for us in Florida. Quality universities, the best we want to make them, obviously the best in the country, but affordable.
And we did it in a year that was, to say the least, a challenge from a revenue standpoint.
Right.
Talk a little bit about that.
We went into this session, to put this in some perspective, 24 months ago, the budget in the state of Florida was $73.5 billion, and it's balanced. It's required to be balanced by our Constitution. So that,
Unlike the federal budget.
You know what? This is a great discipline to have. Floridians should be very proud of the Constitution that they have constructed that we would have to balance. And so if we had a $73.5 billion budget, that meant we had revenues to cover that.
Right.
Today, Ed, the revenue run rate, given the economic challenges that we're facing, are probably in the area of really closer to $63 billion in revenue. So we had to bring expenses down to match the revenue that was coming in. And that was a tough, tough time. But over the last 24 months, we went through, we looked for efficiencies, we looked for, you know, overhead, just as your clients and just like every Floridian is working to do right now in their business model, it was incumbent upon us to do the same, so that we didn't extract more from the business model or from the household budget to fund government when the citizen couldn't get by.
You mean you didn't have to raise taxes?
We now have about a $66 billion budget because we did deploy some of those stimulus dollars that came from Washington, not all of it, but we deployed a good deal of that to support education while we're in this soft spot in the economy, to support infrastructure, and to support federal entitlement programs that we have to pass through to the Floridian as a requirement of our relationship with our federal government partner. So that's what we did, a little bit of stimulus, some significant reductions, and there were revenues in places such as a tobacco surcharge that went into support Medicaid funding.
Right.
So that's how it came together, and I think it worked out fairly well.
So we balanced the budget.
Floridians have a balanced budget.
Great, you mentioned windstorm before.
What's happened, I think, certainly your clients, Floridians, have seen after the 2004-2005 hurricane events that we had, windstorm insurance rates just took off. And we were trying to find some way to arrest the growth rate of windstorm insurance while not creating a marketplace where the major players and others would choose to depart and leave us with less competition. It's been a real tough balancing act, and I'll admit that. This last session, what we did was we allowed for the state-run program, Citizens, which we have capped rates for 2 years, while we hope that the insurance industry would find its footing and with less windstorm damage over the last 2 years, we would start to build some reserves. So we set in place, we released the cap, but windstorm rates cannot go up on any one individual more than 10% a year. There's a projection out there that our windstorm rates in Citizens, those of us who live particularly along coastal Florida, that our rates may be 50% below where they need to be, actuarially sound rates in the marketplace. So we're going to begin to let those rates move, but they're going to have to stay under a 10% cap. We continue to also try to provide support to the private market. And we have now a number of what we call now domestic carriers that are growing that business, and they're actually beginning to take policies out of the state-run program, which is good for all Floridians.
Very good.
You'd rather be in the hands of a private market carrier that understands the business model, that is responsive to you, that's not government managed and run. So that's
interesting you say that in light of what's going on in Washington.
You know, long term, for the best quality of product, for the best competitive environment, we have to count on a private marketplace. And that's where ingenuity and creativity come. That's where people become the most efficient.
What can we expect now that you had 1 year as Senate president? And I know that's a small fraternity of former Senate presidents, including my law partner,
Jim Scott. Right.
Next year, you'll be Senate president, or next session, you'll be. What's on the horizon for the legislature next session?
The biggest issue on our minds going into the next session will still be, how do we create in Florida an environment for private market success, delivering what the public would expect in the areas of Medicaid to support economically challenged households on healthcare expenses, getting to school and getting a quality education while you're there, when you're out at night, that there is a police force and public safety ready to support you if a crisis were to arise in your life.
The future. Your Senate presidency runs through next session.
Right.
And I know that you aspire to be on the cabinet. Tell us about that.
We have a position in Florida called the Chief Financial Officer, and the responsibility of that position to be the guardian, frankly, of consumer protection in the areas of financial services, that person's role to be responsible in a regulatory environment for how the market will either find it attractive to compete here in Florida or disincentives to come to Florida. That position is an extraordinarily important role in Florida, and I believe to Florida's future, the Chief Financial Officer role. And so the current CFO is looking on to other role that to pursue, and so it's created a moment where we've thought about it, and we're pursuing the opportunity to serve in that capacity. And I think it is tremendously important that the player in that role understands again the balance between creating an environment that protects all of our consumers in Florida for not being taken advantage of, and one that role would be of the highest priority, and at the same time creating an environment where people will invest capital, come to participate, compete for Florida business, and be incented to do so in a way that it's an attractive marketplace. And if that happens, more people compete, more products are offered, more opportunity to serve Floridians.
Well, Senator, I appreciate it. And again, good luck in that race for CFO. But we also wish you up. I know you're going to be up for the challenge next legislative
right.
session to balance that budget
right.
and to work on the priorities. And we appreciate your time today.
Thanks so much. So thank you. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you.